Dutch researchers are predicting universe will end much sooner than expected. What do you think on this?
Okay, let's picture this. The universe, you know, everything. It might have an expiration date.
Mm-hmm.
And for, well, ages, we figured that end was so far off it barely mattered. But there's this new study out.
Right.
And it's suggesting the whole show might wrap up quite a bit sooner than we thought.
Yeah, significantly sooner.
Welcome to the deep dive. We dig through new research, find the interesting bits, and lay them out for you.
And today, it's this really fascinating prediction coming out of Radboud University, a sort of revised end date for the universe.
Exactly. So our mission for this deep dive, let's unpack this new timeline, figure out the why behind it, and you know what it actually means for how we see the cosmos.
Absolutely. I'm here to help add some context and dig into the science behind it all. It's pretty intriguing stuff.
Okay, let's start with the old picture. For the longest time, the universe's end was talked about in numbers that were just mind-numbing, like 10 to the power of 1,100 years.
Yeah, I mean, a 1 followed by 1,100 zeros. It's basically impossible to even conceptualize. It felt infinite for all intents and purposes.
Right, total eternity. But this new research, it really shakes that up, doesn't it?
It really does. Mm. This new estimate from the Radboud team puts the end at around 1 quinvigintillion years.
Okay, quinvigintillion. That still sounds enormous.
Oh, it is. It's a 1 with 78 zeros, still an unimaginably vast timescale, way beyond billions or trillions.
Compared to 1,100 zeros?
Exactly. The difference between 78 zeros and 1,100 zeros is just staggering. It implies the universe decays much faster than we pictured.
It's a pretty startling discovery, then.
Definitely a surprising shift. Makes you rethink some basic ideas about how stable things are in the really, really long run.
So what's speeding things up? What's the mechanism here? The study points towards Hawking radiation. We usually hear about that with black holes.
Right.
Can you give us a quick rundown? What is Hawking radiation?
Sure. So back in 75, Stephen Hawking came up with this really revolutionary idea. He said black holes aren't completely black.
Uh-huh.
He theorized they actually very, very slowly evaporate. Over cosmic timescales, they emit this tiny bit of radiation.
Wow.
Well, it happens right near the edge, the event horizon. Quantum physics tells us these pairs of virtual particles pop into existence and vanish all the time.
Okay.
Sometimes near a black hole, one particle falls in, but the other escapes. That escaping particle carries away a tiny, tiny fraction of the black hole's energy, its mass.
And over enough time, poof.
Over truly immense timescales, yes. That slow leak of energy means the black hole loses mass and eventually, theoretically, disappears completely.
Got it. Black hole slowly fizzling out.
Hmm.
But the big news here is that this isn't just for black holes anymore.
That's the crucial new insight, yeah. What the Radboud researchers have shown is that this kind of evaporation, or something very much like it, isn't exclusive to black holes.
So what else?
Their work suggests that other really dense objects, specifically neutron stars and white dwarfs, they go through a similar process too.
Ah, okay. Neutron stars and white dwarfs. Remind us quickly, these are the leftovers from dead stars, right?
Exactly. When a really big star dies in a supernova, its core collapses into this incredibly dense thing, a neutron star. Think materia the size of a city packed into something with more mass than the sun.
Wow.
Oh. And smaller stars, like our sun, eventually they puff off their outer layers and leave behind a white dwarf. Still very dense, very hot initially, and they just slowly cool off.
And we used to think these things, these stellar remnants, would just stick around forever, basically.
Yeah.
Cooling down, but otherwise permanent.
That was pretty much the standard thinking, yes. They'd hang around for trillions upon trillions of years, maybe longer, essentially the final stable objects.
But this new work says maybe not so stable. That these cosmic embers eventually burn out too.
That's the implication. This new understanding suggests that even neutron stars and white dwarfs over these almost unimaginable time frames will also become unstable. They'll dissipate, maybe even explode because of this Hawking-like radiation effect.
Hmm. And that's huge because they're the last things left.
Pretty much. Long after all the active, shining stars have burned out, these remnants are expected to be the last sort of stellar objects dotting the universe. So if they have a finite lifespan,
then their lifespan sets the ultimate clock for the universe itself.
Exactly. Their end marks the true end, in a way.
So that's the core of the revision, then. What calculation did they actually change?
Well, according to Heino Felth, the lead researcher, the older, much longer estimates basically didn't factor in this evaporation for neutron stars and white dwarfs. They just assumed they'd last. fast.
Oh, okay.
So this new study essentially corrects that omission. They ran the numbers for how long it would take these objects to evaporate via this process.
And that's where the one quinvigintillion years comes from.
That's the approximate timescale they landed on for these remnants to finally decay and disappear.
And what determines how fast they evaporate? Is it size? Mass?
It seems to boil down purely to the object's density.
Density?
Yes. Which makes sense, right? It connects back to the idea that this isn't just about the unique physics of black hole event horizons, but something more fundamental linked to gravity and how tightly mass energy is packed.
So denser things evaporate just really, really slowly, unless they're black holes.
Essentially, yes. Even incredibly dense neutron stars and white dwarfs will eventually succumb just over much longer timescales than stellar mass black holes.
Okay, this feels like a big leap. Did it come out of nowhere, or was there earlier work hinting at this? You mentioned a 2023 study.
Right. It wasn't entirely a bolt from the blue. In 2023, Falk's team published research that laid the groundwork. They basically argued that the physics behind Hawking radiation should, in principle, apply to any object with a gravitational field.
Not just black holes.
Not just black holes. They showed that things like neutron stars and white dwarfs should also be capable of this slow evaporation. This latest work takes that foundational idea and runs the calculation specifically for these objects to estimate the universe's end date.
Okay, so the universe might end sooner. One quinvigintillion years. Still an absurdly long time from now.
Absolutely.
Does this actually matter to us? Like, should we worry?
No, not in the slightest. As Falke himself points out, this timescale is so incredibly vast, it has zero practical consequence for humanity or, you know, anything remotely close to our existence. The universe has only been around for about 13.8 billion years. This number is just orders and orders of magnitude larger.
So it's not about preparing for the end.
Definitely not. It's more about fundamental understanding.
Right.
Walter and Salcom, another researcher involved, put it nicely. He said studying these really extreme, ultimate scenarios helps us test and understand our fundamental theories of physics better.
Pushing the boundaries.
Exactly. It could even help us finally get a handle on the deeper mysteries of Hawking radiation itself. It's about that basic human curiosity, wanting to know how it all works and how it all ends.
That is pretty profound when you think about it. And if people want to read the actual paper, the nitty-gritty.
Yeah, the findings have been accepted by the Journal of Cosmology and Astroparticle Physics. And you can also find it right now on the preprint server, R and Chef.
Okay, let's try and wrap this up then. The big takeaway from this deep dive. The universe's predicted end just got a major revision, down from near infinity to about one quinvigintillion years.
Yep, quite the haircut.
And the reason is this new understanding that neutron stars and white dwarfs, the universe's very last embers, they don't last forever either. They slowly evaporate, kind of like black holes do via Hawking radiation.
Precisely. The real sort of aha moment is seeing this connection, this subtle quantum process, maybe more universal than we thought, is ultimately dictating the fate of everything. It's not just a black hole quirk.
It really makes you think, if the universe isn't eternal, even on these vast scales, what does that ultimately mean for physics, for existence?
Mm-hmm.
What other questions does this sooner end date bring up about cosmology and maybe even our own place in this, well, finite cosmic story?
Mm.
Something to chew on.
Definitely a humbling thought.
Thanks for digging into that with us.
Universe will end sooner than expected. How can somebody predict this? Comment it. Thanks.